The Last Democracy, A True Story, by Daniel J. Towsey. Well, where do I start? With a title like that, you might choose to read this article. It's going to be a very simple but shockingly scary one. Disbelieve the story at your own risk. I live in Canada, or what's left of it. This country was once a real democracy. Like many other former democracies from all over the world. Please read my other article. Once upon a time there was a Canada. Please read on, as this article pertains to the USA and also the whole world. I have researched this situation for many years and I have a lot of hands-on knowledge as to the truth that I am about to share with you. First, let me explain to you the simple most important item that makes a real democracy. It is very simple. In a true democracy, the people control the creation and management of money, also known as currency or legal tender, dollars. If the people in a democratic society do not fully control the money and banking system, then they do not have a democracy. It's that simple. For one has to understand that the money controls everything. If you do enough brave in-depth research as to the real truth of the past 100 years, you would discover that all the wars have been created to destroy the financial systems of democracies and replace it with Federal Reserve systems. This has all been financed by the American Federal Reserve. Most Americans still know nothing about the Federal Reserve. They believe that it is a federal government agency, which it is not. It is a privately and secretly owned secret society corporation. Please watch Aaron Russo's America from Freedom to Fascism movie to better understand. The Federal Reserve has never been audited or monitored by the people of the USA. The single worst thing about this is that they have used the ability to create money out of thin air to create the most powerful military in human history. They have used this military and all the secret covert government agencies to systematically take over the world by any means they want. They only abide to one rule. Never get caught, that's it. We are soon approaching the 100-year anniversary of the creation of the Federal Reserve. It is so simple to understand that if the top is corrupt, that over time the corruption will trickle down and eventually corrupt all of society, which is where we are today. Once you understand the power that money wields, then and only then will you begin to understand the most horrible truth. Please remember, this is not a theory. This is all true. And there has been a conspiracy. It is a conspiracy of silence. Everyone is afraid to tell the truth. Remember that bravery only comes as a result of one thing, and that is truth. For without truth you are not brave. The public has continuously been lied to about everything. The worst lie of all is the lie that the American military has been spreading democracy. That is impossible, as the USA is not a democracy. It ceased to be a democracy when the Federal Reserve was illegally created. Today, thanks to the internet, anyone who is beginning to wake up can now start educating themselves and deprogramming themselves of the lies and deceptions that we have all been told all our lives. Unfortunately, the free internet is going to come to an end soon. The process has already started. Download everything while you still can and share it with others. There is only one thing you can do to fight this overwhelming evil. That is to join the Truth Revolution. It is very easy to join. All you have to do is start learning the scary truth, and then you have to do the bravest thing of all. You have to spread that truth. Remember, the most powerful weapon is the seeds of truth delivered with words and not guns, bombs, lasers, microwave weapons, nuclear weapons, biological weapons, etc., etc. I have written many other articles that fully cover what you need to learn. I will provide links to them below. Especially pay attention to the one, Recipe for Insanity. There has been many brave writers trying to tell you the truth and to wake you up before it is too late. That is a very hard thing to do since you have been in a brainwashed condition all your life. Society has been deliberately dumbed down over the past 100 years. We are now at a point where most people have no idea what democracy is, or why you should do everything you can to protect it. You are running out of time. Soon the secret societies, the creators of the New World Order, will have complete control over all of us. Do not accept RFID chips or ID cards with hidden chips in them. For soon they will eliminate the need for money and all you will have is credits applied to your chips. When this time comes, you will be completely controlled. Also, please read my cell phone's article to learn about the invasion of your privacy. Now back to my article. The last democracy. This applies to Canada. For we are the last democracy in the world where the people control and create its currency. And we have our own Bank of Canada. Canadians are not aware of the impending loss of our democracy with the coming North American Union. Once the Union is formed, we will no longer have a democracy, we will lose our sovereignty. I have heard the talking heads in the major medias call the USA Republic and democratic system as just a failed experiment. The idea that democracy is an experiment is absolutely scary. One note I would like to make is that we should never forget that all democracies of the world were created by Christians. This should help you to understand why Christianity has been deliberately and covertly destroyed from the inside. And when that did not work, the countries were simply destroyed by fraudulent wars. All other so-called democracies that the Allies have created in the past 100 years are not democracies at all. They all have Federal Reserve systems where the money is controlled by secret societies. If you want proof, please listen to John F. Kennedy's last speech on secret societies. John F. Kennedy had also started dismantling the Nazi CIA and had already passed an executive order to print American dollars backed by the government. The money had already been printed and he was about to circulate it. On June 4, 1963, a virtually unknown presidential decree, Executive Order 11110, was signed with the authority to basically strip the Federal Reserve Bank of its power to loan money to the United States federal government at interest. With the stroke of a pen, President Kennedy declared that the privately owned Federal Reserve Bank would soon be out of business. President Kennedy's Executive Order 11110 gave the Treasury Department the explicit authority to issue silver certificates against any silver bullion, silver, or standard silver dollars in the Treasury. This order is still valid and on the books. Perhaps the assassination of JFK was a warning to all future presidents not to interfere with the private Federal Reserve's control over the creation of money. In this speech, John F. Kennedy asked for everyone's help. He never got it. He was murdered instead. The newly released digitalized Zapruder film that clearly shows the driver swing a silver handgun over his right shoulder and shoot JFK in the left temple and out the back of the right side of the rear of his head. This original film was painstakingly recreated by professionals who photographed every single frame of the film and made a clear digital version of the original. I also recommend that you watch the movie, The Money Masters. Be sure to read my follow-up article, The Last Democracy is Dead. Please get involved in the truth revolution. When the seeds of truth are sown, the grassroots truth revolution will blossom from the Enlightenment. Written December 1, 2007. DonnieLTowsey.wordpress.com, The Last Democracy.